So Bob Iger just bought Kevin Feige a whole new bunch of toys for Christmas. But the question is, does Kevin Feige want to play with them? Too bad! Bob Iger paid for them, and I'm sure he expects Feige to do something with them, to work his Feige magic. And it's an interesting time for such an acquisition, as Feige is hoping to phase out his more expensive original Avengers for the new cheaper ones. But everyone is wondering if the new batch of characters is popular enough to be the A-team. But looky here! Here's a whole bunch of legit A-list characters. Now, it's important to note that the Disney-Fox deal is probably a year, at least, away from being approved by the government. So Feige has some time to strategize, but Fox also has some time. You know, the employees that are still there, they don't know what their future is. They have a lot of time to either try and secure that future by saying, look what I did, or try and just completely take the ship down with them, right? They're like, F you, I'm gonna force these movies through because, you know, I worked really hard on them and, you know, I don't really care what's gonna happen once the Disney-Fox era begins because it looks like I won't be a part of it, right? So it's a crazy time on the Fox lot right now. but anyway, I'm going to try and tap into the Feige force to both predict slash advise what he'll do with his new toys, all right? So the first thing that's on everyone's minds, all the fans' minds, is Deadpool. And Bob Iger, this is one of the few, you know, I'd like to remind you that Kevin Feige has said a lot of things in the past too. Like, I'm gonna make an Inhumans movie, right? Just because Bob Iger says something doesn't mean it's actually going to happen. But I think that Deadpool is so beloved by fans and Disney would be so hated if they messed with it, that they'll leave it alone. And that's exactly what Bob Iger said. He made a lot of other promises, which is why I qualified his statements for you about, you know, having Fox be its own brand within Disney, et cetera, et cetera. But anyway, I think that you can be confident that Deadpool will not only continue at Disney, but will continue to be R-rated. And I have to say, the first thought that I had as I mulled over this new reality over at Disney and the MCU was that now that Deadpool is part of the MCU proper, they could finally do, perhaps for Deadpool 3, because I think Deadpool 2 is going to do very well, but they could do Deadpool Kills the Marvel Universe as a movie. And those comics are extremely successful. They're also, though, quite graphic. And I'm not sure if Disney, even though they're fine to let Deadpool go on being Deadpool, if they would want their family-friendly superheroes to appear in such a context. Even if it was only in a Deadpool movie, still the screen grab would therefore exist. And also there's another problem which we'll talk about in just a moment. First, I just want to say that I think that Deadpool will continue to exist, therefore, in his own R-rated space, with maybe, now this is an idea I would be very tempted to do if I were Feige, but again, we have a problem coming up here. But I would want to have Deadpool have cameos in all my Marvel movies. You know, a little bit like Hitchcock, like that short in some ways, but just something really funny that would be like a real genuine Easter egg to delight fans. I think that would be a fabulous idea. However, here's where the problem comes up. Now, you might recall that when Deadpool first came out, I said that they should have a PG-13 version. Some people misconstrued my comments and thought that I wanted them to only have a PG-13 version. That was not the case. I just thought that a PG-13 version could play like maybe in the afternoon for families to go to, because the movie was being very aggressively marketed at, you know, kids who shouldn't be able to see an R-rated movie. Now, a lot of kids ended up going to see Deadpool. Some of them had to leave. Their parents had to take them out of the theater. Some watched the whole thing. But that was Fox, and Fox and Ryan Reynolds, I'll never forget Ryan Reynolds was on the Today Show talking to Matt Lauer, of all people, so it just shows you how much times have changed in such a short amount of time. But you know, Ryan Reynolds said point blank, I went to a lot of R-rated movies when I was a child and I turned out just fine. So you know, very openly saying, take your kids even though this is rated R. And it wasn't just rated R for violence, it was rated R for strong sexual content. Now again, Fox and Ryan Reynolds can get away with that, and get away with that they did. They flourished, but Disney cannot have that happen to them. Disney cannot be accused of trying to market an R-rated movie to kids. So since they can't change the rating on Deadpool, and I don't think that they should, because it was so tremendously successful, they have to walk a very fine line here. So if you put Deadpool in your mainstream Marvel movies, can that be argued as trying to market the character to kids? Because the kids will have seen the character in the PG-13 Marvel movie, and then when he has his own movie coming out, they're like, I would like to go and see that, right? I mean, just, that's another thing. With the strong sexual content in Deadpool, Disney does not want those letters. They do not want, when they don't want, let's just put it this way, Disney does want, not want parents dragging their kids out of a Disney R-rated movie. That's really bad. And I also think they have a problem with putting them in the parks, right? I mean, how can you tell kids to go have their picture taken with Deadpool at the Magic Kingdom or Hollywood Studios if they aren't supposed to go and see his movie? So it's going to be a very, it's going to be a real tightrope act, but I think that I think Deadpool obviously will survive. Ryan Reynolds tweeted out something very funny when the deal went through about blowing the Matterhorn. I'm sure Disney's like, this is going to be a real wild ride, right? That'll be the new wildest ride at Disney, right? If Disney fans know what I'm talking about. So anyway, that's what I think is going to happen with Deadpool. He will be the red-suited stepchild of Disney. They'll take his money, but they don't want him to be in the family photo. Okay. Right. And I think that's fine. I think that's the best way that everyone can be happy. Now, I think the foremost thing on Feige's mind and Disney's is the Fantastic Four. Now, I've seen a number of trades say that, you know, a number of just people overall speculate that this will be the property that Disney lets sit for a while. I don't agree at all because, you know, the argument, though, is that audiences need some space. It would be the third reboot for the brand. But you know what? Spidey just finished his third reboot, as many people have pointed out, and that did very well. Plus, Disney's Fantastic Four would be dramatically different than the ones that came before because it wouldn't be accurate. And that just speaks to how far off brand Fox was with their adaptations. And I think that an accurate Disney Fantastic Four movie would seem like a totally different property. You know what it would seem like? A live-action Incredibles. And I think that's just too good an opportunity for Disney to pass up. A superhero family? It's just fantastic. In fact, I would offer it to Brad Bird. I'd be offering it to Brad Bird maybe right now if I were Bob Iger. I wouldn't even talk to Kevin Feige. I'd be like, I'll talk to Feige. I think probably the only person who could influence Feige is Bob Iger. Feige's very powerful at Disney because he makes them billions upon billions of dollars. He's the superhero whisperer, especially if so many other studios crash and burn in the space. That just makes Feige more valuable. But and as for Brad Bird, he's in no position to turn down any live-action gig, even if it cannibalizes his Incredibles brand. And you know what? Just keep Damon Lindelof away from Brad Bird, and I think he'll be fine. Now, you might recall that when they first in Hollywood wanted to make a Fantastic Four movie, there was some discussion of George Clooney and Charlize Theron starring in it. And that's just perfect casting, and they could still do it. I think they're still well cast in the roles. So exciting. You know, the Fantastic Four at one point kind of had the Future Foundation. It was like a school. You know, it's a little X-Men-y. We'll talk about them in just a moment. But I see a lot of potential here, not just for the movies for Disney, but for theme park opportunities. A Future Foundation at the theme parks? Yes, please. All right, now, as for the X-Men, again, this deal is over a year away from being finalized, and Fox is not letting up in the interim on this brand in particular. And again, the deal could not even go through, which is something that some of the higher-ups at Fox are telling their employees as their employees freak out and consider bolting from the company. They're like, don't leave, please. This might all fall through, and we might still have our jobs. So anyway, in a year, Fox is going to be very busy with this brand. You have X-Men Dark Phoenix coming out. You have New Mutants coming out. Gambit will be filming. That's definitely moving ahead. And I would, if I were at Fox, Simon Kinberg, who's, probably wondering what his future involvement is with these movies at this point, although he has worked with Disney before on Star Wars, but I would push that James Franco Multiple Man movie through as well. I would make sure that it films before this, you know, this deal goes through, because I think that's, you know, I don't know if that's a big enough movie for Disney, but it should be. It's a great, great idea. And the James Franco one in particular, because it really is a perfect example of the risks that Fox has taken with this brand so successfully. And I think all these movies seem like they might be pretty good, to be honest with you. And that's why I think Feige will also step back to see how they do at the box office, especially Dark Phoenix when he's deciding whether or not he should reboot and therefore recast. We'll talk about that in a moment. But first, I want to touch on New Mutants. A number of people have speculated that this movie, no matter how well it does, might be just too small for Disney, which Bob Iger reiterated in his investor phone calls that Disney is very much in the tentpole business. That's their main goal in life, to make tentpole movies. That's, you know, if they can get like some small adult awards films, he said, that'd be nifty. But he's in the tentpole business and he makes no apologies for it. So anyway, New Mutants will never be a tentpole, no matter how successful it is. But it's supposed to be a trilogy. So some of the trades are pointing out that the future films in that trilogy could end up going directly to the Disney streaming service. Oh, there's a wrinkle nobody expected, but I think a very real one. And I wonder if it'll be as bad to go to Disney streaming as it is to find your movie suddenly stuck on Netflix. Now, quite frankly, if I were Feige, I would want to reboot and therefore recast. I would be like, have your fun, Fox X-Men movies. And then I'd let them just kind of like fade off and let people forget about them. And I'd give some space. Because he has his own plans of things that he wants to do. He's like, phase four is done. You know, I think he's going to be doing Secret Invasion. So maybe for phase five, mutants start showing up in the MCU. Although I have to be honest with you, I don't really think they fit in the MCU. I thought that Avengers versus X-Men, it was a great marquee event, got a lot of attention, but I thought that the characters, when you were reading the issue, never really fit together. I just don't think the X-Men and the Avengers fit. And I don't think they fit in any of the comics since. You know, they tried to have an Avengers X-Men team, like the Avengers were reimagined as having X-Men on it. It works when Wolverine has been on the team. We're going to talk about him for the finale. But I just think, they put Rogue on there, etc. It just doesn't work. Although, to get a proper Rogue. Oh, I would be so happy. That would just make everything wonderful. Although we'll see if the Gambit movie features her. I think the X-Men, even if Feige decides to do his own version of the X-Men, I really think they should be mostly their own entity. I just think that's how they work best. Now, as for Wolverine, he is always a special case. And Hugh Jackman has said he is not coming back. He had said before that he would be tempted if there was a possibility for him to appear in an Avengers movie. But I think he feels that Logan was such a defining moment in his career and had such finality to it that it would undercut what he feels is, I think, one of the crowning achievements of his career if he were to return. So he's not coming back. So recast, recast, recast. They are not going to let this character languish. I mean, he props up the comics and I think to the movies to the same degree. So I'm sure that Feige is probably already considering who could be his Wolverine. And I think that will be the first X-Men character to show up, the first mutant to show up in the MCU, and maybe be the only mutant in the MCU for a while. A little bit like how Spider-Man showed up. And X-23 is also likely not going to move forward, as much as fans appreciated Daphne Keane's performance. And James Mangold is likely out as well. Feige runs a very on-brand ship. You know, Bob Iger said there might be some experimentation. I don't really believe it, to be honest with you. I think that they want to stay very on-brand, and I think that Deadpool will be the only thing that exists kind of like over here. And I think that's why it's going to be difficult to decide what to do with the X-Men movies, because they're very off-brand. But the Fantastic Four, that's another reason I think they'll be a top priority for Feige and Disney, are very on-brand, both with the MCU and with Disney. All right, so that's my thoughts. That's how I feel about how Feige will move forward. I'm curious what you think he will do and what he should do. Share those thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.